same mark. Just look at one of your neighbors and say, I'm so glad you're in the house this morning.
I'm so glad.
Come on, turn to your neighbor and say, I'm so glad you're in the house this morning. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We pray blessings and peace upon God's people today. Amen. Blessings and peace for God's people today. Amen.
No!
Jesus and all that he's done for us. Every day of our lives, we're losing somebody. Every day of our lives, we listen to tragedies. We listen to the things that are conflicting in the world today. And as I'm pondering, and as I think of how great God is. And I think of how good God is. And I think of how he allows us to wake up every morning. And say, Mark, I have to tell you this morning that when our shepherd of the house came in this morning, he was ready to get started. But the people were not ready to get started. We came in today, we wasn't ready to give God the praise and the glory that he deserves this morning. I'm only being obedient unto the Lord. When the shepherd of the house said, get started, we need to be started. Because we need to thrive, and we need to thrive off the spirit of excellence. And this morning, we did not display the spirit of excellence. God is not the author of confusion. He is the author of peace. He is the author of humility. Say, when we sing like the dew in the morning, it's just simply asking God to refresh us, to restore us, to renew us, to rejuvenate us. That's what like the dew sounds like. So we're going to sing it one last time. And I'm challenging you this morning, Saint Mark, just to freely worship him this morning. And let God just speak to your heart this morning. Amen. So let's sing it again. Hallelujah. We bless you right now. May God be the one.
It is so interesting when praise and worship is going on to see so many non-responsive spirits all night and all day. God's angels watch over and through His grace, His favor, He touched you with a finger of His heart, woke you up, and you still have a portion of your right mind. Able to see a bright sunshine, yes, and to witness His renewed mercy unto you. And yet we come to the house of the Lord, where He is right now, and He's waiting for His just due. And you ought to be able to say, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. What a great God we serve.
Thank you.
Recovery room. The doctor tethered me and my wife. He's got 3 days to a week to live. And we cannot wait. We've got to go now. God gave me such a calm and such peace. I woke up several hours later. They were dragging me off the operating table. And I was able to see a bright sunshine. And the dawning of a new day. Nobody can tell me what God cannot do. I know what He can do. And that's why when I was sitting there and the praise team was going, I just couldn't understand why people who have so much of God's blessings can sit in wonderment as if they don't know what's going on. God has been too good to me. And I know the time is far spent. But when you've been with Jesus, there is no time. Come alive in the spirit. Act like the Cowboys are playing today.
Come on.
Act like you just won the jackpot. Whenever you got Jesus, you got a Super Bowl. You got a jackpot. You got riches and blessings untold. So let's give God His just due. Let's give it to Him. Let's praise His holy name. A mission and education. Okay. You know, when it comes to mission and education, we ought to be cheerful givers. Let our money go where we won't go. Let our money do the ministry that we will not do. It's not a penny offering or change offering. It's an offering for mission. Oh, how I love to. opportunity to support the mission and the educating of those that know you not, and to help sustain the maturity of those that labor in your field. Unto thee, O God, we give thanks. In the name of the Christ we pray. Amen. We have prayer requests today for Gloria Nichols. Nelson, Minnie Williams, Thomas Meadows, and Shirley Thomas, and family. This is an hour that we pause to entreat the Lord for His care and for His blessings upon those who have requested prayer. Big Mama, Range and Turner family, Sharan, and for Elder and family. You know, sometimes it behooves us to come to know our standing before God. Amen. And to see the loss. Many times we are asking God for so much rather than asking God to give us His plan and purpose for our lives. We need to start praying for strength to do His will, to be resourceful in the kingdom, and to pray that God will move us in the direction where the need really is for the lost souls that are spreading abroad around us. Yes, God will supply our needs. Yes, God will heal. God will make a way. But we have to get in His pathway and allow Him to lead us and to be obedient to Him. When we seek the kingdom of God, God will give us the desire of our hearts. And the reason He'll do it is because we've been mature enough to take the blessing and advance that blessing, even though we use it, but to advance it to those who have not. You see, when we pray to God, God makes us the answer to somebody's prayer. And when we earnestly pray His will, we will not seek our benefit, but His benefit, and reflect His love toward others. God says, whatsoever you ask in my name, according to His will, He will do it. And then He says to us, when it comes time to pray, don't be anxious for that. Don't worry about tomorrow. Yes, I've got bills for tomorrow.
Yes, sir.
But God's got a blessing just for you. Don't be anxious for anything. He said, before you even come to your altar, your secret closet, your Heavenly Father already knows what you have need of. So how am I going to get what I need? Be in His will. Do His will. Be pleasing and acceptable unto Him. And God will deliver on His word. Because His will never contradict His word. You can count on God to deliver what He said He will do. And all you've got to do is to line up with His word and His will, and He'll open up doors that no man can close. He'll pour you out blessings that you will not have room to receive. And when He says that, as I always tell you, when He says, prove me, if you get in God's will and you get in God's righteousness and truth, and whatever you do, you just keep proving God, keep proving His word. And God says, when you prove me, I'll open up the window of heaven. And I'll pour you out more privileges. I'll give you more opportunities. I'll give you more advantage. I'll give you so many you won't even know which one to take. But God will never lie. His word is true. You just trust Him. Whatever He says, He's able to do it. If you're sick, and you think you can get well, God is a doctor. He can do all things well. If you need healing, He can heal you. Whatever it is, He's a doctor. He's a lawyer. He can do it all. But all you got to do is to have faith in God. Faith is not believing. Faith is knowing that God can back up whatever He says. That's all you need. Faith will move a mountain. Faith will guide you through. Faith will take your burdens away. Faith will make you concentrate on the author and the finisher of your, that Jesus Christ. You keep looking unto Him, and whatever you're going through, God will make it right. These prayer requests, God can do what He says He can do. All you got to do is to believe and trust in what God says He can do. And we just lift these prayer requests up to the Lord. And we say, Lord, here they are. Take these requests, Lord, according to Your will, and allow them to see the greatness and the goodness of what You can do. And we thank You. In Your Son's name, we pray and we ask. And so it is, according to Your faith, God will do. Let's say amen. Say it again. Amen. That's how simple it is. Turn it over to the Lord. Leave your burden, whatever it is. If you sing, regardless of lung cancer, leave it at the altar. Whatever it is, take your burden to the Lord and what? Leave of that.
Good morning. I'm Lisa Turner. This is time I serve the knowledge in the business. If you're visiting with us, please stand, share us your name or where you're from.
Church where the Reverend John Strong is pastor. And as always, we always enjoy coming to be with you. We want to be and say good morning to you.
Amen. I would like to welcome you to St. Mark Baptist Church. We are so glad that you chose to worship with us today, and we're excited about all things God has been doing and will do in this congregation.
Yeah.
Lives are being changed by the power of God. There can be little doubt that we have very little power on our own for a lasting change to happen in our lives. Yet when we choose to allow the Lord to lead and guide us, amazing things can happen. Thank you for standing. Thank you for coming.
Amen.
And I would like to share the following announcements. Ms. Darrell's trying to search who lost her keys in the parking lot. If anyone can claim these, please see Sister Bruce. Okay, the youth children's church will be every third and fourth Sundays in the St. Mark Education Center. We are starting practice on Wednesday at 7 p.m. for the Easter program. We'll be passing out Easter speeches and practicing for the Easter play. For those that will not practice for the Easter program, we'll still have our normal Wednesday night Bible study. That's from Sister Mary.
Amen.
The Oasis Ministry and the North Texas Food Bank will distribute food items on Thursdays, March 7th and March 16th from 12 p.m. to 2 p.m. The annual church cleanup will be Saturday, March 11th from 8 a.m. to 12 p.m. The men's ministry members will do most of the outside work such as lawn work, painting, etc. But we're asking other ministries to do some inside work. We have identified some areas that need attention, and the list will be given to the ministry leaders. We are also asking that you bring the cleaning supplies and tools. The work does not need to be done on March 11th, but if your ministries want to do an area and you have any questions, please see Brother Deacon Woody Threes. The music in the park will be Saturday, March 18th from 12 p.m. to 5 p.m. If you want to participate in the mass choir for this event, rehearsals will be on Thursday, March the 9th at 7 p.m. The Texas State Missionary Baptist Convention semi-annual session will be held in Temple, Texas on Monday, March 20th through Thursday, March 23rd. The session will convene with 8th Street Baptist Church, 215 MLK Jr. Drive. Temple, Texas, 76501, and Reverend Roscoe Harrison is the host pastor. If you need hotel information, please see the flyers in the lobbies of the sanctuary and the education center. The 33rd annual pastor and wife appreciation service will be on Sunday, March 26th, during morning worship. The theme is be thankful for the gifts of pastors. And the scripture is Jeremiah 3:15. The colors are lime green and navy. There will also be a dinner after church at the Outback Steakhouse, located at 3903 Town Cross Boulevard, Sweet, Texas, 75180. If you plan to attend the dinner, please see Sister Annie Crowder or Sister Deborah Morgan by Sunday, March 12th. Everyone will be responsible for their own meal tickets. Everyone will be responsible for their own meal tickets. We have been asked to be there about 1 p.m. so we can be seated according to our reservation. You may also bring gifts. It is our hope and prayer that as many as possible will come and join in and be, as we show love to our first families from the past day of the community.
Amen.
The matron and the ministry will offer free food items after church service in the real church. Now the food cook-off is called I Am a Christian by Ed Sullivan. I am a Christian and I love the name, nor will I shrink from fear, guilty or shame. to tell the world that I belong to God, redeemed and washed in the atoning blood. I am a Christian and I bear the cross, though it exposed me to grief and loss. My loving Lord, who hung upon the tree, endured the cross, a heavier one for me. I am a Christian, cheered with inward grace, and by the smile which beams on Jesus' face. Oh, may I act a Christian and proclaim the saving power of the Redeemer's name. I am a Christian and I hope for heaven, because in Christ I feel my sins are forgiven. Tis but a little while till he shall come and take me with his ransom people home. Have a blessed week.
Amen. Good morning.
Good morning.
Amen. So this is the moment in our service where we honor Black Heritage Month. And so we have the drama ministry that has prepared a little skit, and it's actually a monologue that we're going to let our brother Young, bless him, come in his own way, so you know we got to be proud. And so, we're going to have Brother Marlon come first to kind of open it up. This speaker that we have today, he's coming in his own way, as I said before, and he hails from the greater New El Bethel, Cogelistic, Apostolic Church of God and Christ, Baptist, denominational, and you know all the rest. So he's going to come after the singing of this wonderful Brother Marlon Jackson that we have here today, who's going to give us a rendition, and he's going to come in his own way. You may know this couple as, those who know him call this couple Reverend P and P, which is his wife, but we know him personally as Reverend Pig Feet and Sister Fortune. So as Brother Marlon comes, then we'll render the floor to Reverend Porchop and Reverend Pigmeat and Sister Porchop.
Yeah. I Thank you.
far. That our service is here. Also, we'd like to thank our praise team today. All day. As we know, the fourth Sunday is our sermon night Sunday, and we had the Reverend Mr. John Strong to come in to visit with us here today, and his wife from Victory Church. And I asked that our associates would allow him the hour today, and they so graciously agreed to do that. And so we are graced today to have with us the Reverend Mr. John Strong, whom I have known for several years, and I want you to be in prayer for him as he comes to break the bread of life with us today. Would you do that, St. Mark? The Reverend Mr. John Strong will now come as the Lord has led him. You know, sometimes it's not a sudden moment, but it's a moment that God has led someone to come this way. And when that happens, I don't want to prevent the blessing of the Lord to come before us here today. So he's not going to come in his own way. Would you receive him now?
Let's go visit our friend, Pastor Madison. Amen. Amen. And Sister Madison upon today. And thank you, St. Mark, for having us, to all of our preachers. Amen. Thank you all for an opportunity. Amen. To be able to preach today. Amen. Share God's word to the deacons. Amen. And to the choirs and praise team. Amen. It's just good to be here. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Can we come and enjoy ourselves coming to be with y'all? This me, of course, of song. Amen. Old Luther was, it sounded like Luther singing. Amen. Yeah, I'm talking about Luther Bond, not Luther. Come on now, come on. Y'all talking about the other Luther. I'm talking about the Christian man, Luther Bond. Amen. Amen. And I just thank God for everybody. Amen.
I love to praise Him. I love to praise Him. I love to praise Him.
I love to praise His
name.
Oh, I love to praise.
Yeah. I love to pray.
from the book of Exodus, the third chapter of the book of Exodus. Again, reading with verse 1. Now Moses kept the flock of Jethro, his father-in-law, the priest of the Midian. And he led the flock to the backside of the desert. He came to the mountain of God, even to Horeb. And the angel of the Lord appeared unto him in a flame of fire, out of the midst of a bush. And he looked, and behold, the bush burned with fire, and the bush was not consumed. And Moses said, I will now turn aside and see this great sight, why the bush is not burned. And when the Lord saw that he turned aside to see, God called unto him out of the midst of the bush and said, Moses, Moses. And he said, here am I. And he said, draw nigh hither, put off thy shoes from off thy feet, for the place whereon thou standest is holy ground. I want to talk this morning to you from the subject. I want to talk about what if shoes could talk. My brothers and my sisters, I wonder upon today, if shoes could talk, I wonder what would they say about me? And then I wonder what would they say about you? I really do believe that if shoes could talk, it probably wouldn't be very many folks at church today. Because shoes would tell what we done last night. Then shoes would tell all that we done upon this week. Not only would it tell, but it tell what we say about each other. Right. Can I get a witness here? Shoes would tell how many hypocrites that is in the pulpit. Shoes would tell how many hypocrites on the deacon board. In the choir. Are y'all with me here? On the usher board. And then shoes, when it excludes nobody, will tell how many sit in the congregation. Can I get a witness here? Shoes will tell why some of us stop coming to church. Can I get a witness? Shoes will tell how many excuses we make, the reason why we don't come to church. Shoes will tell the real reason why we stopped coming, didn't want to hear the gospel. Are y'all with me here this morning? If shoes could talk, they would tell us that we're not as holy as we claim to be. Shoes would tell how we love to give God praise the one minute
and then stand at him and cuss. Y'all ain't gonna help me. The next minute. James 3:10 says, out of the same mouth proceeded blessing and cursing. My brethren, these things ought not to be. Are y'all ready to hear? Do a fountain send forth at the same place sweet water and bitter water? Oh, your shoes could talk. They would tell us the people that we call our friend is really not our friend. Shoes will also tell us that some family members are not really, I don't know if I've been, as close as they claim to be. Can I get a witness here? If shoes could talk, they would tell what we said behind each other's back. Who we like, and then who we dislike. Can I get a witness here? Shoes would tell the latest gossip. Tell us what goes on behind closed doors. Shoes would tell us what goes on at the church. And then shoes will even tell us what's going on our job. Shoes will tell us what we said on and off the telephone, in the dark of the night, when we're whispering softly, or when we're talking loud. Shoes would tell how fake some of us really can be. Are you aware this morning that shoe and a man both have something in common? Are y'all with me here? A shoe has a tongue, a soul, and a body. A man has a tongue, a soul, y'all pray with me here, and a body. A shoe, a right shoe, and a left shoe make a pair. Can I get a witness here? When I see a man with another man, that's two left shoes. Stay with me, church. When I see a woman with another woman, that's two left shoes. Have you ever tried to walk with two left shoes on your feet? It won't work. It's very uncomfortable to wear two left shoes. When I see men with men, I simply said that's two. Y'all pray with your head. Left shoe. And then, you know, it takes the right man with the right woman. Y'all ain't gonna help me here. And they're called a husband and a wife. Are y'all still with me here? I wanna know this morning if shoes could talk. Will they tell the truth? The whole truth. And nothing but the truth. Or will they become comfortable in lying like me and you? Are you still with me here? The question was asked, Everybody. Somebody said, certainly. Certainly, Lord. That the Lord knew, and he knows that we lie. That we say a lot of things that just sound good, but really ain't good itself. Are you still with me here? I wonder if shoes could talk. I wonder when they tell how divided that our homes, our churches, and even on our job, how divided that we are. Husband and wife not speaking to one another. Sleeping in the same house, but ain't sleeping in the same bed. Are y'all still with me here? I told Sister Strong a long time ago, they were telling me about when you get married, you gotta be careful when you be on the couch. I told them then, I'll tell them now. I'll throw that couch out there.
Are y'all praying with me?
Sister Strong, I just said hello.
Yeah.
Y'all ain't gonna help me here. And a woman's hair is her glory. And she took glory to white glory. Are you with me here? The Apostle Paul, he stated, in order to put on the whole armor of God, or to complete it, we must put on our spiritual shoes. Can I get a witness here? Don't get dressed up. You ain't got no shoes on. Y'all ain't gonna help me here. Never forget one time I was at a convention and I had on a blue suit and I thought I was clean. I was turning around there, old country boy. That blue suit on with some black shoes. I thought I was clean. One of the pastors that married me and my wife pulled me to the side. Said, John, what you got on? You know, when you get clean, you just change the way you walk. I stood there, chest out. He said, let me take you to the store. Carry me to the store. He said, you ain't matching. You look good, but you ain't. Y'all ain't gonna help me here. Carry me to the store. Bought me some brown shoes to go with my blue suit. Change my tie. You sure don't contend me nothing then. Sometime you need somebody to help you to dress. Question to be asked, where did you get dressed at? In the dark? Y'all ain't gonna help me here. And you know what you find about some folks? Spiritually.
Yeah, yeah.
I dress him in. Y'all ain't gonna help me here. You know, I have discovered that there are all types of shoes.
Yes, sir.
I ain't got but a few more minutes, Doctor. See, I learned that a car had brake shoes. Always trying to stop something. A horse had horseshoes. Always playing games. A track runner wear a track shoe. Every time you see them, they're in a hurry. And a hunter wear a hunter shoe. Always trying to kill something. Let me ask you a question. And I'm getting back in my text. Have you ever worn shoes that was too tight? On your feet. You look at all cute. I'm wearing some of it. You looking good. And you got them tight shoes. Are you still with me? You know you really wear leggings. How about you 9 1/2? You ought to come down. It is what it is. One day I work at a school, DISD. And I put my, you right, baby. I had my suit on, looking good. had a brown suit on this time. Just a brown shoe. Walk around the alley, walked into school, they said, "Pastor, you look good today." And I was saying, "You ain't got to tell me that. Some things I already know." Y'all gonna help me? 9 o'clock, 10 o'clock, 11 o'clock went by. I'm sitting around there with them shoes on. My feet start hurting. I took them nice looking shoes and made slides out of them. Stop faking it. Because I gotta make it. And somebody know what I'm talking about. Sometimes the first thing you put off when you get out of church is them shoes. I would say, how y'all do it walking them heels we have been there. Call yourself looking cute. It won't be long, you're gonna get up out of them. Are y'all still with me here? Shoes are not prejudiced like a lot of us. And you know, some folk got so many shoes. Is that right? They got a shoe for almost everything. And all the men say it. Amen. Amen. Don't be scared. Don't be afraid, men. Men got shoes too. Right. You know, some of us got some Sunday shoes. Right. Is that right?
Amen.
We call them church shoes. And then some of us got some everyday shoes. You call them house shoes. And then some of us got some party shoes.
All right. All right.
Or some gambling. Y'all ain't gonna get shoes. And then some of us got some dancing shoes. And if you ain't careful, you'll wear the wrong shoes to church. Without shoes, our feet would have no protection. Shoes provide comfort. If your feet hurt, your whole body, y'all ain't gotta sit up. If shoes could talk, they would tell us who been stepping on our toes. If shoes could talk, they would tell us how they've been treated or been mistreated. If shoes could talk, they would tell where they have been. And they'd also tell where they're going. If shoes could talk, they would tell how many crimes that we have committed in our shoes. And I text here on today, God had a job for Moses. But before God could send him, he had to take him through something. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. And prepare Moses for something. Yes, by telling Moses to put off, are y'all with me here?
Yes, sir.
His sinful shoe.
Yes, sir.
Because the ground
yes, sir.
That he stood on.
Yes, sir.
was holy ground.
Yes, sir.
And do you not know where you're sitting and standing right now is holy ground?
Yes, sir.
And you can't do in and everything on holy ground.
Yes, sir.
Is that right?
Yes, sir.
The children of Israel were in bondage for over 430 years.
Yes, sir.
And God needed somebody. He needed somebody to make a change. He was tired of his people being in bondage. And this is why God equipped Moses. Are you still with me here? You see, God did three things with Moses. Can I tell you what they are? The first thing, he showed himself a burning bush that would not consume. And you know, some of us just knows it. And God knows we knows it. Is that right? And Moses went towards the burning bush. But then as he got there, he showed himself. But the second thing he done to him, he told himself. He said, draw nigh, draw near hither. In other words, Moses, come a little closer. And that's what the Lord is saying to me and you. Come on a little closer. Is that right? I wonder why everybody wants to sit at the back when you ought to come to the front. Is that right? I know that he's everywhere. Can I get a witness? But since I've been saved, I like to make my way to the front. He's the same yesterday, today, and forevermore. Moses, he told him something. When it came closer, the Lord said, put off that shoe for the ground that you're standing on is holy ground. And I stop by to tell you that all, I said all of our shoes got something to say. Did you hear me? Yes, yes. Whenever you come to the Lord, you got to pull something off. Can I get a witness? Abraham's shoes told God he will provide. Noah's shoes told God that the ark is finished. Jeremiah's shoes told God one day that I quit and I make mention of your name no more. But I hear Jeremiah saying, it's like fire shut up in my bones. David's shoes told the Lord, created me a clean heart and renewed. Make me preach on and renewed the right spirit in me. Isaiah's shoes told the Lord, no weapon formed against me shall prosper. Did you hear me? Yeah, Joshua's shoes told the Lord, as for me and my house, we gon' serve the Lord. Moses his shoes. While he was standing there, he asked God a question. If you're sending me, who should I tell them that sent me? And God says, I am that I am. Can I get a witness? Yes. I told you, he showed him something. I told you, he told him something. But the third thing, he gave him something. God gave Moses a message to tell Pharaoh that I said, let my people go. Can I get a witness? Yeah, I thank God that over 2,000 years ago, yes, in a little city called Bethlehem, Jesus, he was born of a virgin, stopped off in Bethlehem, yes, rode that train, can I get a witness, came through 42 generations, yes, and when Jesus came to this world, one day he came in my life, and he changed my shoes. He changed the way I walk. I don't walk like I used to walk. He changed, changed my talk. I don't talk like I used to talk. I can truly say, I know I've been changed. The angels, I read the angels, the sign, sang my name. When he met me, he told me, strong, pull off your shoe. I pull it off, pull off that old life, pull off your backbite, pull off everything. Can I get a witness? And I came to Jesus just as I was. I was weary, living in sin, but I found in him a resting place. And now, he made me glad. Moses pulled his shoes off. God said, the ground you're standing on is holy ground. Holy ground ought to make you do holy things. You ought to change your life. You can't keep on them worldly shoes and serve a holy God. You got to pull them off. You can't keep doing what you used to do. You got to put them off. And then when you put them off, he'll give you some brand new shoes. They match your brand new suit. God won't have you looking rich now. He'll put the right thing on. Cost you his time. Can I get a witness here? Christian ought to have on the whole arm of God that we can stand against the wiles of the devil. God says, strong, let me match you up. Let me dress you up. Can I get a witness here? He said, the reason why I want to dress you, because Satan looks at everything that you have on. Some folks just notice everything you got on. And if Satan see you coming in with your right shoe on your left foot,
and your left shoe on your right foot. Satan will say, I got him. He might have on the whole armor of God, but it ain't right. Satan bothers us. And if you said Satan ain't bother you, could be a reason. If he ain't bothered you, he might already have. You might not be doing nothing for him to bother you. But when you start walking with the Lord, the old folks used to say like this, that Satan is on my track. And he's trying hard to turn me back. And I keep on marching. Good things happen to those that march with the Lord. God bless you. God keep you. Jesus Christ. What is this? Make folks settle down, acting strange. What is this? Got me wanna run on in Jesus' name. Whatever it is, it won't let me. Oh my peace. I ought to have a witness here. What is this? Make folks say I'm acting strange. What is this, Lord? Got me wanna run on in Jesus' name. Keep on setting my soul on fire, whatever it is.
Get this picture hanging up for you. Be with the man for the hour today. Yes. Reverend Strong, be with the man for the hour today. Thank God. I was blessed by your word today. We're now up to our time of giving and receiving. We want to afford you an opportunity to participate in this time of giving. This is for Sunday. And on for Sunday, we allow those of you, if this is your Sunday, to give your regular offering to do so. We have our two deacons here to represent that. And then Sister Bunny Crowd is coming. She's going to stand on behalf of the pastor lady. So if you would like to make a contribution to that, you're more than welcome. Ursula, you've been faithful today and took us to do so. I ask that you would come now and help us with this time. Out to this past week over in the Ed Center right after church. So parents, if she has contacted you, if you would please meet with her right after church over in the Air Center. She's over there waiting on you right now. She's not going to hold you long. And then the Oasis Ministry will be taking pictures immediately after church. If you would like to be part of this picture-taking moment, please meet up in the choir stand as soon as church is over.
Church, amen.
Amen.
This has been a beautiful day of experiencing God's grace and mercy. I want to thank associate ministers for allowing Pastor Strong to come and say a word. He did not he preached from his heart today. For a minute there, I thought he'd been get undressed up here. You know, the Lord can change it, but... Thank you so much, Pastor, for coming and being here. Sister Strong, thank you for allowing your husband to come and visit with us here today. And our prayer always will be that God sustain you in all that he does for you, that you can in turn do for him. The gifts for the babies, the twins, today was the day, but we're extending next Sunday also that you would show your kindness to the two twins. Amen?
Amen.
Where are they today? One over there and one over here. All right, they are really growing. And we want to be a blessing to these young folk. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. And I know that the pastor's aide has taken up an offering today. And I'm going to ask that they would be kind enough to donate that offering to these two twins today.
Amen.
Would you do that? Yield and it shall be given unto you. Amen. Pressed down, shaken together, running over, shall God give into your blessings. Amen. We always want to be an inspiration in the lives of these children because their mother was actually born in this church. And we always want to allow them to know that St. Mark is and will be a blessing to them. Amen.
Amen.
And to some of our young folk who have come off of the campuses this week who are sharing in the youth church today, I want to thank them for being a part of this church and continuing their fellowship with the church. Amen. Now, parents, one more thing before we have last words. Parents, please. The youth department of St. Mark is still in existence. We have graduated a lot of young folks, but please be a part of the St. Mark Young Church. The children that you now bear are the church that is on the rise and on the move. And if they don't have the basics of Christian foundation, how do you expect for them to remain on the Lord's team if they don't know how to hear the plays that God is calling through the Spirit? You know, Satan is competing against our young folk, and he's doing a great job. And if you don't think Satan is advertising his kingdom, you just turn on Facebook, you turn on Twitter, you look at television, you go to their schools. Satan is recruiting our young folk, and we are failing the kingdom of God by not combating that flesh and the spiritual warfare that's going on in them. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. If your shoes would tell where you was last night, well, I forgot you changed shoes this morning.
Our last words and remarks will come from Pastor Strode. Something was said today that will be a blessing to you. What shoes to talk about? I woke up, and you know, you work all week long preaching, you know, getting your sermon together, getting things together, because you don't ever know where the Lord may send you. And I was like, Lord, what should I preach today? And he said, if shoes could talk, I said, where am I going? You the master. I learned a long time ago, the wind bloweth where it list. That's when you told Nicodemus that whatever direction the wind is going in, that's the direction that you go in. I came out of here, pastor today, and he said, are you ready? Amen. Learning as a pastor and preacher, young preacher, you have to be ready at all times. Amen. Amen. And I thank him, his wife, the deacons, and his whole congregation, especially the preachers, that give up, amen, this Sunday, amen, just to let, amen, God's preach, amen, at this church, amen. Thank you, amen. We go on vacation. My kids a lot of time. My son and daughter's back there. I call them John Boy and John Girl, but her name is Shania. My children are back there. Y'all just stand up. My son and daughter, that's my baby boy and my baby girl. They're back there. God, for them coming, amen. Today, you know, it's kind of like when I went to church. When we go to church, Pastor Matt, we didn't have a choice. Right. When mama said you going to church, grandma said you going to church, you couldn't tell them I ain't going. Right. If you did say that, then when you got up off the floor, right. I promise you'll never tell them that anymore. Amen. Right. My children don't have a choice. Don't get in the house with me, they're going. The Bible said, train them up. Two things I was raised up with and I raised them up with. That's a Bible and a devil. Did y'all hear what I said? A Bible and a bell. And then I teach them a good book and they don't want to listen, I take this off. I'll teach them again, amen. Amen. Let us stand. When I had my shoes off, amen, my feet was Dennis Mayer. They did not. Amen. Pray for us in DIST. I work at SOC every day, where I work around children that think that they grow. Y'all pray for us, amen. Pray for SOC the nation that God would bless us, amen. Young people in the house, if you have an opportunity to get your education, get it. Quit playing around and get your education. Amen. And once you get that, they can't take it from you. You see, it didn't matter to me who became president. Amen. I wanted somebody else to win. But when they got it, God said, strong, I'm still in charge. Watch the sun come up. Come on, somebody. God said, I'm in charge. Man can only do so much that I allow him to do. Amen. And every night, every day, I keep praying that God, thank you for being in charge. Amen. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you today. Bless Pastor Madison. Bless his wife. Bless the deacons. Bless the male chorus. Bless the musicians. Lord, bless the members of this congregation. Continue to strengthen all of us. Bless your churches, God, that's planted by your hand. In the name of Jesus. I thank you for another day, God. In Jesus' name. Now may the grace of God, communion of his Holy Spirit, rest, root, and abide here now and forevermore until we all meet again. Let this congregation say amen. 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 God bless you. Let the church.
Amen.